Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to do a little deep dive into Danielle Kahn's complete history online and how she rose to fame, as well as a few updates on her feud with Tana Kahn's organizer, Michael Waste. But before we get into it, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and turn your post notifications on. Also, make sure to check out my T Twitter account if you have any news, tea, or drama. The DMs are open for that as well. But let's get into it. Danielle Kahn rose to fame back in 2016 on TikTok before TikTok was kind of even a thing, aka it was just called Musical.ly. She quickly became one of the most followed figures alongside Jacob Sartorius and Lauren Gray, and was sponsored by big companies such as Samsung and Target. Danielle's status on Musical.ly immediately caught her family's attention, especially her mother, Jennifer. Jennifer invested a lot of time and resources making sure that her daughter Danielle would become a successful figure online, sometimes no matter the cost. In 2013, Danielle participated in beauty pageants, and later on, she was crowned Miss Florida Junior Preteen Queen back in 2015. When she took home the crown, she did an interview with Teen's Weekly Insider and said in her interview why she decided to join Musical.ly in the first place. She said, "I started Musical.ly at a rough time in my life. I was just kicked out of my dad's house, so I started Musical.ly to clear my mind. I got my first feature in February, then I was crowned in March at 150,000 and has been growing ever since. I have 46 features and close to 4 million followers. Musical.ly has changed my life." Danielle and her father, Dustin Kahn, have publicly fought online, and it seems like the two don't necessarily have the closest relationship. She later revealed in that same beauty pageant interview that she was approached by a company called BMG and was a working model for them. In 2017, her family took it upon themselves to move from Florida to Los Angeles, filled with the aspiration to further develop her career. She dabbled in singing and released her debut single, Marilyn Monroe, which as of 2021 has been viewed over 15 million times. Ever since then, Danielle has been a controversial figure on all social media platforms. Her very first Musical.ly video was of young Danielle, who barely looked 4 feet tall and seemed even too young to be posting on social media. But shockingly, after 2 years, Danielle was posing in provocative poses and posting them on Instagram. On almost every post, commentators started questioning her true age. But in 2019, Danielle's father, Dustin Kahn, took to Facebook to reveal Danielle's true age and posted her birth certificate for the world to see. On the certificate, it is documented that Danielle was born in March of 2006, which would have made her 13 years old when her father posted the certificate on Facebook, contradicting Danielle's previous claim, stating that she was born in March 7th of 2004. According to Distractify, Danielle shared a document on Instagram with her alleged birth date and wrote this as her caption, saying, "I have the best life and make my own decisions, so tired of this. Listen to someone that has nothing to do with me and also took my mom to court before I was famous because he didn't want to pay child support." She continues and says her father is an alcoholic and abusive to her mother. She wrote, "You guys have no idea what you're talking about. He was so embarrassed that he didn't even tell his wife about me until I showed up one day asking for stuff. Never supported anything I did, was never at my cheer or pageants. Why did it take him 3 years to come and say something?" In another post, Danielle's father voiced his opinions and concerns about Danielle's social media presence and her mother, Jennifer's, parenting decisions. He wrote, "I've decided to set things straight about my daughter, Danielle Kahn. For years, I've done the diplomatic thing while dealing with my daughter being online in a way that I didn't approve of and trying to have it handled out of social media because I figured the system would work and keep my daughter safe. I was never married to her mother, Jennifer, and Danielle is my only child with her. The only person I have ever married is my wife now, Heather. Danielle and Jen did live with me from birth till around 10. I allowed her to stay at my house despite not dating for 10 years, rent-free so we could both take care of Chad and Danielle. Danielle is 13. I have never liked Danielle being on social media, especially when she started at such an early age. But pageants and modeling and then Musical.ly were all pushed on her. It was always a huge problem to me. I asked for it to stop immediately, which it didn't. We found Pinterest boards with her photos, and I told her mom I was worried about else. Danielle's father has since deleted his Facebook posts about her. And now, also, according to Distractify, Danielle's stepmother Heather took to Instagram to post now deleted text messages between Danielle and her father. I could not find any screenshots of these messages, but allegedly, Dustin texted Danielle saying, "Danielle, you can think and say what you want, but I was there all the time, even when you FaceTimed me at night when mom was not. I was never here to be your friend. I was your father and not worried if you don't agree with me. One day you will see life is too short to fake your life every day and have to figure out a way to protect your lie that you and your mother have created. It's sad to me and I feel bad for you." In defense of Danielle, her brother Chad claimed that their father was addicted to marijuana and did indeed have problems with drinking. He stated that he would go quote unquote ballistic if he was going through withdrawal. Chad claimed, "I remember on multiple occasions he would grab the knives that my grandfather would buy me for fishing. He would grab those knives, lock himself in the garage, and threaten to kill himself." In 2020, Dustin posted a video describing his relationship with Danielle.
"When I posted that post about a year ago, since then I have not seen Danielle. She has not been sent here. She is definitely not happy with me because of that post. I care about my daughter. I love my daughter. I wish I was with her as often as I was supposed to be with the custody agreement that I fought for in court. But to me, the way it's being done, I feel like as a 14-year-old, she could sing and do whatever she wants online and be completely fine without having to post herself in the way she's being posted. Dating a now 18-year-old is confusing to me."
After her very public breakup with her now ex-boyfriend Mikey, her age would once again raise a few eyebrows. Mikey is a fellow social media influencer and is most notably known for his TikTok videos. Mikey and Danielle reportedly dated from June of 2018 to December of 2020. When they first announced the relationship, fans of Danielle were strongly against it since Mikey would have been around 16 years old in 2018. And if Danielle's father is telling the truth about her birthday, that would have made Danielle around 12 years old when she started dating him. If she was born in 2004, like she claims that she was, that would make her around 14 years old in 2018. Note that Danielle also dated another influencer called Sebastian Topet from around 2017 to 2018. Sebastian was born in 2000, which would have made him around 16 years old, and Danielle around 11 years old if she was born in 2006. Mikey and Danielle have caused a lot of drama here on YouTube. From a fake marriage to a fake pregnancy turned into a PSA announcement while still under the age of 18. Let's just say that didn't go so well with Mikey's parents. Mikey's mother, Katie, wrote on his Instagram account via stories that she no longer supported Mikey and Danielle's relationship, saying, "This is Mikey's mom, Katie. After some sensitive information was brought to my attention about Danielle, we no longer support Danielle and Mikey's relationship. Because Mikey is still a minor, we have taken away his social media. He will able to get it back after we've worked through some legal stuff. Thank you." After that, Mikey's dad took to Instagram via stories and revealed the news that Mikey wanted to get emancipated. He wrote, "I love my son very much. All I want is for him to be safe with himself and his decision. As parents, we need to protect him from any harm that might come his way. He wants to be emancipated, and I understand that, but his emancipation can give him prison time. Danny is not 15. Shortly after that, Danielle went live on Instagram and spoke against both of Mikey's parents in his defense.
"Mikey's parents, I know that I said that Mikey should be the one to do this. But at this point, I'm not gonna have these two grown adults come over here and threaten me. First of all, Mikey's dad isn't Mikey's real dad. So before he wants to come on social media and say anything, you are not his real dad. You are just with his mom. You guys didn't even care about him. You kicked him out to the street because he was tired of you guys taking his money. They take every single penny of his money. No wonder the kid wants to get emancipated."
Mikey then went on Instagram Live himself under a different profile explaining his side of things and even stated that he didn't want anyone knowing where he was.
"I went outside and my mom was in the car and she was like, what do you need to talk to me about? And I said, I want to be emancipated. My parents are just crazy. With that being said, my dad said, exactly, but you're taking that away from me. And I said, I'm not taking that title away from you of you being my dad. I'm taking the control away."
In 2020, an audio recording between Danielle and her mother, Jennifer Archambault, was leaked online. The person who released the audio was Jennifer's best friend of 5 years, Virginia, who can be heard in the audio. Take a look.
"Do this at this age. I'm letting you do that. I allowed you to have an abortion. And this is all the shit that they're saying on there. I allowed so much that I shouldn't have allowed. And it's allowed you to be the person you become. And just think it's okay to act the way you can towards me. We don't have a relationship.
Can I talk?
Just forget.
Really quick?
No, wait. I want to just touch base on two things that you said.
What?
I'm going to take the f***ing microphones. Okay?
She thinks everything's a fucking...
It's not... She's a child. This is what kids do. And no offense, when my mom talked, I would laugh. It's so fucking funny, and I get slapped in the face. It's a reaction. That's not maybe how she feels. But you saying the things that you're saying to this girl is fucking beyond me, Jen. Like, if you really think about it, if you step back and say, let me be my daughter, and let my mom say this to me, would this be okay? It's not okay. Your daughter went through something fucking beyond terrible that you, as an adult,
all over the internet.
It doesn't matter. You're the one that possibly allowed it on the internet, too, because you don't know how to fucking isolate also. It's something that happened in your daughter's life. I don't give a fuck about social media. You should care about what your daughter personally feels. Have you sat with your daughter and said, hey, Danny, how do you feel emotionally what you've been through?
You make disgusting comments about the abortion all the time.
You shouldn't. That's the worst thing.
You said to me, you were like, at least I didn't kill my child. You
You say that out of anger.
Okay, but that's a different type of thing.
No, it's not. Because you do the same shit to me. And then
I
do
it
back.
You say freaking childish insults is a different
You say a lot worse shit. Don't even go there.
In an email to Insider, Danielle's mother confirmed that audio recording was indeed a real interaction between her and her daughter. She said, my best friend of 5 years that my daughter looked up to and was very close to is behind this disgusting situation. I am sickened and beyond hurt that an adult that was this close to our family would betray us. Danielle then took matters into her own hands and released a YouTube video titled, The Truth About My Abortion. She goes on to say that she was a victim of sexual coercion and that she felt embarrassed that she had to come forward and make a video about a very private and vulnerable experience. She details her grieving process and said that she felt completely alone during the time that she found out she was pregnant to the time that she was going through the process of abortion. At the time, Mikey and Danielle were broken up and said that he did not support her and wanted her to have an abortion. Jennifer took to Instagram to address the situation more and said, it's super unfortunate that everyone continues to think my daughter isn't happy or we're doing everything wrong, but yet every time the police come and investigate or CPS and everyone else comes and sees our family, they don't understand why they even have been called out to investigate. It's sad that everyone continues to waste their time and takes resources away from actual major problems in the world. On August 7th of 2021, Danielle made a video titled Addressing the Hate Plus Full Truth. In this video, she defended her mother and talked about her FanFuel account, which is a platform similar to OnlyFans where you can post exclusive content and pay a subscription fee to view. Danielle stated on numerous occasions that the account includes content that is no different than what she would normally post on Instagram. She claims saying that P-words can pay and view the content is redundant since a P-word can view her Instagram for free. She defends her mother and says this.
I don't know what the hell's going on with everyone calling me about my mom lately. Everyone's always like, oh my god, your mom's forcing you, oh my god. No. My mom, she doesn't care what I post, to be honest.
Later in the video, Danielle says that commentators have said that her mother, Jennifer, stole her money, which she denies and says that her manager forged her signature and took all of her money, not her mother. At that time, she did not reveal who the manager was. Of course, fans had speculations, but as of August 2021, Michael Waist, who's been notably known for the shit show that was TanaCon, has come forward as Danielle's ex-manager. He posted a video titled, The Truth About My Client, Danielle Kahn. He starts off by saying that in a situation like this, he would normally comment through his attorney or take other legal measures, but says that this time he wants viewers to have an understanding about the situation. In this video, he claimed that he spent about $50,000 on Danielle and her family. This money went to her birthday dinner, party buses, contributed to their move from Florida to Los Angeles, and discounted her music video productions. He later learns that Danielle lied to him about her management, saying she was already signed somewhere else, and states that he would not have invested all of this time and money if he had known that he wasn't going to manage her. Michael says that he was actually never her manager. He goes on to say that Danielle and her family took him in as a family member and that they would go on trips to Disney World together, even temporarily living together at a point. Michael said that he knew Danielle since she was very young and then they both started working on projects projects and a documentary together called Obsessed. Filming of the documentary was halted indefinitely since Michael said it got very, very dark and he became quite uncomfortable watching Danielle and her mother's dynamic. He says that Jennifer would take advantage of her daughter's success. Michael recalled a time that Danielle had apparently told him she had $300,000 in her account, and a couple months later, her mother took the vast majority, leaving her only with like less than $10,000. He recounts a time that he witnessed Danielle and her mother having an argument, which led to Danielle pulling him aside to reveal her real age. And at the time, she revealed that she was just about to turn 16 years old. So she was 15 years old, which would mean her father was telling the truth about her birth year if Michael managed her around this year. Michael said Jennifer would exploit her daughter, telling her to post provocative photos of herself to garner more attention. He said Jennifer would get phone calls and scream to the person on the other line and then proceeded to play a clip from the unreleased documentary. Michael stated that Danielle was being abused by her mother and now has an understanding of why they were supposedly 30 CPS cases against her. He talks about a time that he got Danielle's new boyfriend, Mason Peterson, who is another TikTok influencer, out of a criminal charge. Mason reportedly brought a butterfly knife on a freaking plane. Michael says that he got him out of that situation and he had his attorneys take care of it. Michael says even though Mason wasn't aware of Danielle's real age and if there was a sexual or romantic relationship between the two, it would be considered statutory rape since Danielle was still a minor, according to his attorney. Mason had bought Michael Cartier earrings, thanking him for getting him out of his criminal charges, but Danielle took this the wrong way and thought Michael was seducing Mason and stealing him away from her. She publicly posted via a friend a shady TikTok about Michael. Michael spoke with Danielle's friend who posted the TikTok video and recorded the phone call.
I was on the phone with Danny and Jen when I made it too. It's a draft that I had in my TikTok.
Yeah.
And legit, I was like, haha, should I do this? It'd be funny. And Danny was like, yeah, do it. It's funny. And I said, okay, cool.
Michael says Danielle's claims that she's pansexual is false, and she's even muttered the words, I will never date a girl, and that she would never date Mason if he was bisexual or anyone who is bisexual in general. But later, Danielle's mother went to Michael and said she has not received any of the income from her daughter's music videos. So Michael went ahead and submitted claims for the videos so she could start making some ad revenue. Supposedly, Danielle and her mother mistake this as Michael stealing her money and YouTube account, even though she signed ownership of the channel to Michael and his management team. Out of confusion, Michael went on to text Danielle, only to receive no response. This resulted in Michael refunding offers from huge brands like Netflix and Danielle refusing to promote her music. Michael sums it up and says he tried his best and just wanted to help Danielle out, but ultimately feels disrespected by the circumstances. Danielle responded with a video speaking about Michael and his claims against her titled, "The Full Truth Plus My Experience Working with Michael Waste, Horrible." She starts off by saying she was never his client, which Michael did say in his video. He said he was never her official manager. Danielle states that she told Michael that she was already signed with another management, but they said that she could work with another manager as long as there's no contracts involved. She denies Michael's claims that her mother is sexualizing her and states that she posts all of her pictures on Instagram by her own accord. Danielle then explains the clip of her mother screaming on the phone, saying it was shown without context and that the phone call that her mother was on was with a man threatening to sue her for making him watch their dog. She quickly shows text messages with the man threatening to sue to further her point. Danielle then says that Michael had developed feelings for his assistant and she felt uncomfortable with Michael pursuing his assistant. The assistant allegedly got uncomfortable with Michael himself and ended up quitting. She later talks about Michael's claims about her sexuality and said that she felt really offended by his statements and denies ever saying, I would never date a girl. Danielle says that Michael would do anything he could to sabotage her relationship with Mason, and then from that point felt uncomfortable being around Michael unaccompanied. She started bringing her mother along for meetings with Michael, which Michael mentions in his video, but views it as her mother inserting herself in every aspect of her life. Danielle says that she already knew about the Cartier earrings before Mason gifted it to Michael and that Michael viewed it as a romantic gesture, stating that he has a problem trying to turn people who are not gay gay. She then says that Michael started blackmailing Mason to distance himself from Danielle. In Michael's video, he says he was advising Mason to stay away from her since she was still a minor. In Danielle's video, she says it was because of Michael's crush on Mason and he wanted her out of the picture. The timeline of each situation lines up in each of their videos, but their perspectives on each topic is extremely different, so it's kind of hard to tell who here is being truthful. Danielle says Mason is not bisexual, and even if he were bisexual, she wouldn't have a problem with it since she's pansexual. She then says that her adopted brother was sexually assaulted by Michael Wace. Danielle then addresses the situation regarding the submitted claims on some of her music videos. She says that Michael forged the IP address and forged her signature to make money off of her. Danielle then brings Mason into the video to make a statement about the situation. Mason says that he never said he was bisexual publicly or privately to Michael. He addresses the alleged blackmail that went on between him and Michael, saying Michael told him that if he stayed in contact with Danielle, he would go in jail for statutory rape and a breach of contract, and apparently stated that he would turn his misdemeanor into a felony charge. They sum it up by saying that Michael is a weirdo and has made so many false claims, as well as made unfulfilled promises about brand deals and anything involving their career. That, for some reason, I kind of low-key believe. Just Michael Wace just seems sketchy. Like, I don't know, man. On August 22nd of 2021, Michael made another video titled The End of Danielle Kahn's Lies. He immediately starts off by saying Danielle's video failed to show any proof, which is sort of true, but she did have Mason as a witness, and Michael did provide screenshots and videos, but it did seem like a few clips were taken out of context to further elaborate his point in his first video. He addresses this in his second video and says the clip of Jennifer saying Danielle would look good with a piercing was supposed to show Jennifer's negligence as a mother. He says that a good mother should not be allowing her child to be covered in tattoos and piercings at 15 years old, and the clip of her phone was supposed to show the audience a pattern of behavior and why most of their situations end in lawsuits. He said her story on how they met is false and that she did indeed know him longer than what she claimed, and even stated that she was at TanaCon. Michael then said that it is true that Danielle told her she did have management, but he did not know she was still affiliated with that management. He then calls out Danielle's reluctance to even address the age situation. Regardless, he says that she should not be posting explicit photos as a minor and that her mom should step in as her parent to take them down. Michael then addresses Danielle's claims about his assistant, Dylan, and says that he did not quit for the reasons that Danielle said in her video. Michael said that Dylan witnessed a sex crime that Danielle was involved in and felt uncomfortable staying around. He even showed his letter of resignation. Michael admitted that he thought Dylan was cute, but denied ever having romantic feelings for him. He then FaceTimes a woman named Hannah and asks her if she witnessed Danielle saying she would never date a girl or anyone who's bisexual.
Y'all, in this video real quick. Hannah, did you or did you not hear Danielle, while we were at Disney, say the words that she would never date anyone who is bi?
Yes.
Period.
Michael then recalls a time that he wanted to go on a drag show with Danielle and claims Danielle refused since she was just like, it's just men dressed up as women. Danielle allegedly continued saying that she knew what it was like to be a real woman since she had an abortion. Michael denies ever blackmailing Mason and simply texted him out of concern and said he could not let him commit the crime of statutory rape. He addresses Danielle directly and says he never took Mason's gift romantically, saying that she was the one who took it romantically. He once again shows more screenshots addressing Danielle's claims of forgery and ultimately denies all of them. Michael says he never outed Mason's sexuality and says he said the words, if you were bi. Michael didn't address Danielle's claim about the alleged SA on Danielle's adoptive brother.
She accuses me of sexual assault on her adopted brother. I have a plethora of content proving otherwise. Very clearly, even comments on your video and said that that's not true.
Says Danielle put him in an uncomfortable situation and that he witnessed Danielle's sexual acts while he was staying at her home. He provides screenshots of invoices and bank statements proving that Danielle did owe him money. Basically, Danielle and Michael repeat themselves a lot and tell stories about the opposing person, and they run in circles a lot. All right, yeah, that was it for that video. If you made it to the end, you're a real one. Let me know down in the comments down below what you think about the situation. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked it, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every single day. All right, bye.